Good morning, dear students. Myself, Dr. Varun Narayan Mishra. Today, I am going to discuss about differential GPS, which is a part of GPS technique. And in the last class, we have discussed about the concepts, the processes, and methods in GPS, that is global positioning system. So now, today, I am going to discuss about what is differential GPS, what are different types of GPS or DGPS surveying, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of different DGPS techniques. So before starting about the DGPS, first we should know what is the differential, what does it mean. Initially we use GPS, but because of the selective availability, okay, we started using differential GPS. So until year 2000, the civilian users had to contend with the selective availability. Okay, the Department of Defense intentionally introduced a random timing error. Okay, means whatever the signal we are receiving, it is having some delay in the time, it is having some errors, that is intentionally, that is known as selective availability. Means we are bound to use the random timing errors in the satellite signals, so that we will not have the precise information about the position of any real world object or earth surface feature. So in this way, we can say that whatever the signal we are using, or whatever the, you can say, whatever the timing and positioning we are receiving from GPS satellites, it is having some errors. That timing, that error in the timings is introduced by the Department of Defense USA, so that we will not have the most precise information about the objects. This kind of process is known as selective availability. Okay, so this selective availability is a kind of error that is intentionally introduced in the GPS signal that limits the effectiveness of the GPS and its potential misuse by the adversaries or enemies of the country. These timing errors could affect the accuracy of the reading by as much as 100 meters. Okay, so to avoid these kind of errors, we use the word differential. Okay, so as now selective availability is removed, so the signal that is coming from GPS satellite and received by the GPS signal, okay, from any manufacturer, we can use the GPS from any manufacturer that can achieve the accuracies of approximately 10 meters. Now our GPS receivers, whatever GPS receiver we are using of any company, we can achieve the accuracy of approximately 10 meters. To achieve the accuracies that is needed for the quality GIS records from 1 or 2 meters up to few centimeters, it requires differential correction. Without differential GPS, we can have the accuracy up to 10 meters. But if we want to improve our accuracy up to centimeters, so that we require some differential correction, and the receiver used for this process is known as differential GPS. So the majority of the data that is collected using GPS for GIS is differentially corrected to improve the accuracy. Without using differential GPS, without performing differential correction, we cannot achieve the accuracies up to centimeter level. Okay, so differential GPS, or in short we call it as a DGPS, it is a relatively simple technique to improve the positional accuracy and integrity. This technique was developed in early 1980s and it is widely used in various forms. Okay, so DGPS is a kind of GPS process, it's kind of GPS technique that requires differential correction, that requires some processes to correct the errors that is received by the GPS receiver. So it is a method. DGPS is a method to improve the accuracy of our receiver by adding some local reference station. Okay, without DGPS we are having only single GPS receiver, but in DGPS we are using two GPS receivers. So the entire process or the entire mechanism is known as DGPS, and it improves the accuracy of our receiver by adding some local reference station. We use one of our GPS receiver as a local reference station that is used to augment the information available from the satellite. It also improves the integrity of the whole GPS system by identifying the certain errors. So without adding a DGPS method, we cannot identify the errors in the GPS receiver. So to identify the errors in the GPS system, to correct that errors, we need to have DGPS method or DGPS technique. Okay, so differential GPS uses one unit at a known location and a rover. In DGPS, we are having two receivers. One receiver will be used as a base station and another receiver will be used as a rover. So it's a kind of rover and base station kind of processes in which the stationary GPS receiver, that is base station, one GPS receiver will be at stationary position. It will be at the constant or fixed position. That is known as base station. So that this stationary unit or the fixed position of any GPS receiver comprises its calculated GPS location with the actual location and computes the error. And the rover data is adjusted for the error. Okay, and the GPS receiver, which is moving motion, or we use another GPS receiver that we use it by moving throughout the study area to collect the data, that kind of data is adjusted for the error. So in differential GPS, we use one GPS receiver as a base station and another GPS receiver as a rover receiver. So we use rover receiver, we move into the study area, we move over the study area to collect the data set that is used to adjust the errors caused by the different types of aspects and different types of processes in the GPS. Okay, so the underlying premise of DGPS is that any two GPS receivers that are relatively close together will experience similar atmospheric errors. We know that the GPS signals that is coming from the GPS satellites having some effects of the atmospheric conditions that may cause different kinds of atmospheric errors, topographical errors, it may be atmospheric errors. Okay, so that is a kind of errors that is caused by the atmosphere. So DGPS requires that a GPS receiver that will be set up as a precise known location. So out of two GPS receivers, one GPS receiver will be established at a known location, and this GPS receiver is the base or known as reference station. Okay, the base station receives the signal and calculates its position based on the satellite signal because its location is already known to us. So it can easily identify, it can easily calculate the errors caused by the atmosphere. Okay, that the GPS receiver is known as base station or reference station, and it compares this information with the known location and collects the errors caused by the atmospheric effects or any other kind of error in the GPS signal. Okay, so the difference is applied to the GPS data that is recorded by the second GPS receiver. One GPS receiver is fixed, its position is known to us. It is having fixed latitude, longitude. So that information will be used to correct the data, correct the errors caused by the received by the second GPS receiver, which is known as roving receiver. Roving means move karna. Okay, we use this rover receiver to move throughout the study area and to collect the data sets. But if we are moving, so that kind of that receiver receives the signal that may have some errors because of the atmosphere and other regions. So that error can be corrected, can be reduced, or can be removed by applying the methods, by applying the corrections caused by the GPS receiver at the fixed location or any known location. So the corrected information can be applied to the data from the roving receiver in real time in the field using radio signals or through the post-processing. So I will discuss later that how many types of GPS or DGPS surveys there are, what are the advantages and disadvantages of different kinds of DGPS surveying. So differential correction technique are used to enhance the quality. We use differential DGPS to correct the errors and to enhance the quality and precise information, precise location of any real world object or any earth surface feature Okay, and the quality of the location and quality of the positioning of any feature, any data sets gathered using global positioning system is caused by some differential GPS. Differential correction can be applied in real time directly in the field. Okay, we correct it real time in the field also. No need to go to lab and post-process that data set. In some cases, we need to apply post-processing in the lab, but in most of the cases, the differential correction can be applied in the real time directly in the field. Okay, or in some cases, we need to require to have, we need to have some post-processing data in the office. Although both the methods are based on the same underlying principle, that is, assessed different data sources and achieves the different levels of accuracy. So combining both methods provides flexibility during the data collection and improves the data integrity. So we can correct the errors in the field, or we can use some post-processing softwares, we can use some lab to process that data set to correct the errors in that data. We have both the options, okay? So depending on the requirement or depending on the facilities available, we can either collect it in the field, or we can use it, or we can get that data set in the lab, and we can use some post-processing softwares to correct that error. So real-time DGPS means the data sets, whatever we are receiving from the DGPS receiver, that occurs when the base station calculates and broadcasts the correction for each satellite as it receives the data. In the field, at the time of the receiving of that signal from the GPS satellites, it continuously and automatically corrects that error in the field also. That is known as real-time DGPS. Real-time DGPS means all the corrections can be done in the field also, just after receiving the signal from the GPS signals. So these kind of corrections is received by the roving receiver via radio signal. So if we are doing a real-time correction, if we are doing correction in the field, so that corrected information will be sent to the roving receiver via radio signal or via any Bluetooth connection or any other mean of the communication. So as a result, the position displayed and logged to the data file of the roving GPS receiver is a differentially corrected position. So we can have two options. We can do real-time corrections, or we can have that data set, we can collect the data, and we can post-process in the lab by using some softwares. We are having both the options. Satellite differential services. Now another method for obtaining the real-time differential correction data is the field, is by using geostationary satellite. Okay, geostationary satellites can also be used as a tool, as a process to correct the differential correction in the data sets. This system obtains the corrections from more than one reference station and sends the information to the geostationary satellite for verification. We have another option to do the real-time correction. We have another option to perform the differential correction in the field by using geostationary satellites. So this geostationary satellites can have the facility to correct the GPS signals from more than one reference station. Okay, we can have multiple reference stations, and the information collected from multiple reference stations can be used by geostationary satellites to correct these kind of errors in the data in the field itself. Okay, and it will be verified by geostationary satellite at the time of the correction. So this verified information is sent to the roving GPS receiver to ensure it obtains the accurate position in the real world object or in real time. So this is another method, but this method requires some connection, some communication with the geostationary satellites. So in some cases, it is not possible to communicate. It's not possible to make the communication or connection with the geostationary satellite. So we generally use two methods. One method in the is the correction of the errors in the field itself, and another method is to perform that correction in the lab by using some post-processing softwares. So we should have the option of both the either in the field or we can do it in the lab itself. So what kind of errors in GPS signal? So we have already discussed in the last class, there are several errors that affect the accuracy and precision of the GPS signals. Okay, there are several errors possibilities in the GPS. Okay, why errors caused in the GPS signal? There are several reasons behind this. Okay, if the GPS receiver is not synchronized with the atomic clock in the satellite, then it causes some kind of error. Okay, and the estimate of the position of the satellite, speed of the light is only constant in the vacuum. Multipath error should be there. Okay, ghost signal from the reflected radio waves. Selective availability is a kind of error. Okay, then not free sight to many enough satellites and noise in the receiver. So these are some kind of possibilities. These are some possibilities that can cause the errors in the GPS signal. So we need to overcome these errors. We need to rectify these errors to get the precise location in the real world, the precise location of any real world object, to get it with different positioning and timing. Okay, so now all the errors have been already described. What is multipath error? What is ionospheric error? What is selective availability error? Okay, sometimes you will have that your GPS receiver is not synchronized with the atomic clock, because the GPS satellites having atomic clock, they are very precise in the timing. And if your GPS receiver, whatever you are using on the earth, it is not synchronized with the atomic clock in the satellite, then it will cause some error. It will cause some delay in the timing, in the measurement of the timing. So that can cause some kind of errors. We should avoid these kind of errors. We should first synchronize our GPS receiver with the atomic clock of the satellite. These are several kind of sources. Means these are several sources of errors in GPS signal. And in the right, in the second column, you can see the error in the positioning, error in the location. So if we are getting ionospheric error, we are getting error because of the ionosphere, that will lead to the error in the positioning up to 4 meter. Another kind of error may be because of the clock, that will cause the error of 2.1 meters in the positioning, plus minus to 1 meter. Ephemeris error causes the plus minus 2.1 meter error in the GPS signal. Troposphere also having some effects on the accuracy and precision of the location of real world objects, that may have 0.7 meters error. Okay, receiver noise is also a source of error that can cause the error in the positioning up to, you can say, 0.5 meters. Multipath error can lead to the error in the positioning up to plus minus 1 meter. So if we collect or if we add all these errors caused by different sources, caused by different regions, we may have total 10.4 meters of error. So at a time of the data acquisition, at the time of the receiving of the GPS signal, if all these kind of errors are there, if all these kind of sources of errors are present in that time, so we can have the total error in the positioning, that is up to plus minus 10.4 meters. Means we are having the errors in the position of the object, or there is a error in the location of object, that is up to 10.4 meters. That will be plus minus 10.4 meters. So we, if you are getting the data sets, if you are collecting the data sets of a position, so it may be shifted from the actual position by 10.4 meters. That's a kind of positional error. That is a kind of positional errors in the accurate location in reference to the real world object. So this is the sources of errors. All the sources of errors have been already described in the previous classes. Okay, now this is the figure showing different kinds of errors. There may be the errors because of GPS clock error. There may be error because of ionosphere. There may be error because of troposphere, because ionosphere and troposphere can delay the GPS signal to reach to the earth by the receiver. Okay, there may be multipath errors if you are collecting the data sets, if you are collecting the GPS coordinates near to a tall building, near to very tall rock or any tree, that can cause multipath error. Ephemeris error may also be there. So the GPS signals, whatever the signal we are receiving on the ground, whatever the signal is received by the GPS receiver, they may have these kind of errors. At a time, all the errors can be there, or a few errors can be there. Out of all the errors, maybe there are some few errors, but in some cases, maybe all the errors are present during the data acquisition. Okay, so there is a possibility of having all the errors, or there is a possibility that only few errors are present during the data acquisition or during the acquisition of the coordinates. Okay, so these errors should be rectified, these errors should be removed before using that GPS coordinate, that GPS data for any further application. Because if you directly use the GPS signal received by the GPS receiver, that may cause the error of 10.4 meters, which is already discussed in the last slide. Okay, so that will affect your positional accuracy. So it may cause some errors in your calculation, it may cause some errors in the results. So we need to rectify all kinds of error by using differential GPS. Differential GPS helps us to rectify the errors caused by all these kind of sources, either from GPS clock receiver, ionospheric delay, tropospheric delay. There may be some errors because of the receiver noise. There may be error from the multipath, ephemeris error. All the sources of errors, the errors caused by all these sources can be rectified, can be removed by using the differential GPS or DGPS. Okay, these are some common errors that is caused in the GPS signal: noise, biasness, blunder, clock. Okay, it's already discussed with all of you. So how we can address the errors caused by different sources in the GPS signal? So all the errors, or you can say the errors caused by multiple sources, can be addressed, can be overcome, or can be removed by using DGPS. It eliminates or reduces the clock errors, the path error, that is multipath error, ephemeris error, and ionospheric errors. It means by using DGPS, we can eliminate or we can reduce the errors caused by the clock, multipath, ephemeris data sets, and ionospheric effects. So the idea is that the errors are almost the same for two GPS receivers that are close to each other. Okay, so out of two GPS receivers, one GPS receiver will be placed at a fixed location, that is fixed receiver on a well-defined location. Its location is known to us, and we compute the error in the position by using the known location of that GPS receiver that is established, that is fixed at a fixed location, and it is used to estimate from the satellites signals coming from the satellites and calculate the backwards to find the time error and broadcast it by radio to another receiver. So this is the way, this is the idea behind using the DGPS to rectify the errors caused by multiple regions. Okay, so moving to the next slide, noise error. What is noise error? Noise errors are the combined effect of the code noise around 1 meter and noise within the receiver. Okay, sometimes our receiver doesn't work properly. Sometimes the signals come received by the GPS receiver having some noise because of the internal system error of the GPS receiver. That can cause the error of around 1 meter in your positioning. So that is a noise error. If your GPS receiver doesn't work properly because of some internal structure. Bias error, having selective availability, is a bias error. It's type of bias error. It's the intentional degradation of the signal by the time varying bias. Selective availability is controlled by the Department of Defense, Government of USA. Okay, ephemeris data error may cause 1 meter of error in your positioning. The satellite orbits are constantly changing, as we know that, and any error in satellite position will result in the error for the receiver position, because ephemeris data includes the positioning of the satellite in the space. So whatever the data sets we are receiving, whatever the signals is received by the GPS receiver is having ephemeris data sets. That ephemeris data having the information, having the positioning or information of the positioning of different satellites in the space. So if the satellite moves at the time of image acquisition, in the time of data acquisition, so that might cause some error in the satellite positioning. Okay, so these are some error. Differential GPS of USGC. Okay, so USGC means the differential GPS was used of and managed by United States Coast Guard. USGC, Maritime Differential GPS. It's a kind of GPS, you can say DGPS is a system that is managed and controlled by US Coast Guard, USGC. It employs ground stations along the coast with known fixed locations. Okay, and the corrections that are transmitted from the ground station at low frequencies, that is around 200 to 500 kilohertz, and it requires an additional differential beacon receiver and an additional antenna. Accuracy is a function of the distance from the ground station. So if there is a large distance between the base station and rover station, or you can say the reference station, which is fixed at a fixed known location, and your rover receiver that are moving in the throughout the study area, if the distance from base station to the rover station is increased, there is large distance between these two errors, these two signals, or you can say the signals coming from these two receivers, that may have the more possibility of the errors. Okay, so the accuracy is a function of the distance between these two GPS receivers, but whatever the GPS receivers used in the differential GPS setup. Second is WAS, Wide Area Augmentation System. The Wide Area Augmentation System is also managed by FAA. It communicates with several ground stations. It provides the atmospheric corrections. It's early warning of GPS failure, some frequencies as GPS. It's higher data rate at 250 hertz, and satellites are in the geostationary orbit. So WAS is another topic. It will be discussed in next class, because it's an entire different topic of the DGPS. So it's not in your syllabus, but I will try to discuss about WAS, Wide Area Augmentation System. It's a different type of technique. It's based on GPS technique, but it's a little bit different from DGPS. So it will be discussed in the next classes. Okay, so this is the figure showing the Wide Area Augmentation System. In short, we call it as a WAS. Okay, it is the augmentation to the GPS that provides the ability to conduct precise approaches using GPS receiver. Means in WAS, all the GPS satellites in the GPS system, either in the ground or in the field, okay, all the stations on the ground, all the GPS satellites in the space, and all other GPS installed in aeroplanes and other locations on the earth, they are well connected with each other. That's why it's known as Wide Area Augmentation System. Augmentation means entire GPS system, either in the space or the stations on the ground, or any other GPS installed on the airplanes or any other kind of instruments, they all are connected with each other. That is known as Wide Area Augmentation System. We call it as a WAS. Okay, so this is another topic. It will be described in next class, what is about the WAS. Okay, but this is not in your syllabus. This topic is not in your syllabus, but I will try to discuss about WAS, okay, after completion of your syllabus. Okay, it is, you can say, it is the broader form of the GPS. GPS only connects a GPS system only having the GPS satellites in the space and the ground stations on the earth. But the Wide Area Augmentation System, that is WAS. WAS includes the entire GPS, entire satellites of the GPS system, or entire ground stations, entire other sources of GPS, like in the aeroplanes, in the helicopters, in the other ground stations, all are connected with each other. That is known as wide area augmentation system. Okay. So yeah, this is the figure showing the wide area augmentation system. So you can have some basic idea by observing this figure. This figure is showing multiple GPS satellites, that is GPS constellation of GPS satellites. Then you can have different geostationary satellites. You can have ground control stations. You can have some local area systems that is installed on the, you can say on the airplane, on the aeroplane, on the coast guard, or any other location on the earth surface. So the wide area augmentation system, or WAS, includes the signal coming from all over the world in a combined platform, on the combined platform, so that can be used to collect the information about any real world object with more precise accuracy. Okay, so this is known as wide area augmentation system. Okay, it's another topic. It's a very lengthy topic to discuss, or it will be discussed after the completion of your syllabus. Okay, so this is the figure showing the basic idea about wide area augmentation system. You can have some basic idea by observing this figure, how different GPS satellites, how different geostationary satellites, how different control stations, how different ground stations and local reference systems, aeroplanes, all are connected with each other. Okay, this is the wide area augmentation system. It will also very much useful for the navigation purpose. Okay, in navigation purpose, this wide area augmentation system is very much useful, because when we move in the sea, so in the sea, it is not possible to all time collect, every time collect the GPS signal. In that case, we need to have wide area augmentation system that will also use the signals coming from the geostationary satellite to get the positioning, to get the location on the real world object. So how we can calculate the position? So for calculating the position of any point on the earth surface, first we measure the distance of that point to the satellites. Then again, in the next step, we obtain the position of that satellite. Then we perform the triangulation calculation. This is trilateration, and then we adjust the local clock biasness. These are the four steps that is used to calculate the position of any object on the in the real world object on the earth. Okay, first we measure its distance to the satellite, then we calculate, or we identify the, we obtain the satellite positioning, then we perform the triangulation calculation, that is known as trialteration. Okay, trialteration means we should at least having the signal coming from three GPS satellites, three satellites. Okay, after getting the that signal coming from at least three satellites, we can have the triangulation calculation, and after that we adjust the biasness or errors caused by the clock that is in the GPS receiver on the earth. Okay, so for measuring the distance, we use very simple formula. Distance is equal to velocity into time. We know the velocity of GPS signals. Okay, and we know that how much time it takes to reach to the ground station from the GPS satellites, and on the basis of the velocity and time taken by the GPS signal coming from the satellite to the ground station, we can calculate the distance. Okay, the velocity is that of radio waves. The velocity will be known to us. Time is the travel time to the signal, and after multiplying velocity with the time, we can measure the distance. The GPS receiver generates the same code as the satellite, that is known as PRN code. Okay, and it measures the delay between incoming code and the self-generated code, that is known as selective availability. Okay, the whatever the signals we are getting, it measures the delay between the incoming code and the self-generated code, that is known as selective availability, and D is equal to speed of light into measured delay. Okay, so this is the basics. This is the basis for measuring the distance between the ground station, or you can say the GPS receiver on the earth, and satellites moving in the space. For getting the satellite positioning, for getting the position of a satellite in the space, first an important parameter is ephemeris data. As we have already discussed, ephemeris data includes the actual positioning, actual position of the satellite in the space, that is also known as orbital data. Each and every satellite sends its orbital data in the form of ephemeris data. It is embedded in the satellite data matches. Whenever the signal is sent by the satellite to the GPS receiver, that signal also having the orbital data, that is known as ephemeris data. Ephemeris data contains the parameters that describe the elliptical path of the satellite, and the GPS receiver uses this data to calculate the position of the satellite in the form of XYZ. Whatever the signal we are receiving by the GPS receiver, that is sent by the GPS satellites in the space, that GPS signal, the signal received by our receiver, will also having ephemeris data. That ephemeris data describes the path of the satellite, and that information can also be used to calculate the position of that satellite in the space at the time of data acquisition, at the time of acquisition of the coordinates on the Earth. So now I am going to discuss about what are different GPS surveying methods. What are the surveying methods that are used in GPS survey? What are the methods for using GPS for surveying of purpose? Okay. So as already we know that differential GPS is a technique for reducing the errors in the GPS that is derived the position by using the additional data from reference GPS receiver. Whatever the signal we are receiving by GPS receiver is having some error. So GPS is a method to reduce or to eliminate these kind of errors. Okay. These kind of errors can be removed, can be eliminated by using additional data from a reference GPS receiver. When we use another GPS receiver, then we can easily rectify, we can easily reduce the errors caused by the different factors in the GPS signal. So, and the use of two GPS receivers is known as differential GPS. Differential position accuracies of 1 to 10 meter are possible with the GPS. By using two GPS receivers, by using GPS system, we can have the positional accuracies up to 1 meter or less than 1 meter. So this is the figure. In this figure, you can see, okay, you can see the systematic diagram of the working of differential GPS. There is a reference station which is fixed. Its location is known to us. Okay, it is also receiving the signal from multiple satellites, multiple GPS satellites, and our, you can say, the rover station or rover GPS that is not fixed. We move by using this GPS receiver. It is also having signal coming from different satellites. Okay, so the errors caused by the different factors and it's received, and then the signals received by the reference station and the rover station will be used to correct the time delay, will be used to correct the errors in the GPS signal. On that GPS signal will be rectified in the field also, or you can have the facility to use this data to be post-processed in the lab by using some softwares. So this is the simple diagram showing the working of differential GPS. So what is the need of differential GPS? As we know that each GPS receiver uses the timing signal that is from at least four satellites. We require at least four satellites to get the positioning and timing of any object, any point on the Earth that is used to establish a position, then each of these timing signal is going to have some errors. Okay, that is a kind of delay in the GPS signal depending on what sort of problems have occurred on its journey down to the Earth. There may be multipath error, there may be ionospheric error, there may be tropospheric error, there may be other errors. So the whatever the signals coming from the satellite, coming from the GPS satellite to the station on the ground, they may have some kind of errors or delay. Okay, since each of the timing signal that go into the position calculation has some error, that calculation is going to be compounding of those errors. So using a modified form of GPS that is known as differential GPS, in differential GPS we use two GPS receivers, it can significantly reduce the various inaccuracies in the GPS system and pushing its accuracy even better. Differential GPS involves the cooperation of two GPS receivers. As I have already discussed, one is established at a fixed location, that is stationary station or stationary position, it is known as base station, and another that's roving around the study area making positional accuracies, that is known as rover. So in differential GPS we have two GPS receivers, one is at base station and another is used as a rover. Okay, this stationary receiver is the key. It ties all the satellite measurement into a solid local reference. Because the stationary station or stationary receiver is having some known location, so there is a possibility that the errors caused by multiple sources may be rectified by that base station, and that information will be sent to the rover station, rover receiver, and then we can have the more improved accuracy in terms of position. Okay, so this is the way in which we need to have differential GPS. Okay, there are several methods of differential GPS. Okay, when we are going to use differential GPS, it is having several methods: static differential GPS method, rapid static differential GPS method, and real-time kinematic or RTK differential GPS method. So in the next class I will discuss one by one what is static differential GPS, what is rapid static method, and what is real-time kinematic method. These are the methods of DGPS survey. Okay, but each and every method having some advantages, disadvantages, each and every method having various levels of accuracies in terms of position and timing. Okay, so it will be discussed in the next class. I will discuss about different kinds of differential GPS surveying methods. Okay, so today's class is over now, and if you have any question then you can ask here, and all your quizzes are uploaded on LMS. You can attempt your quiz related to today's lecture on LMS, and after that you can just join to another class. Thank you very much for today's lecture.